name's Henry Trotter. He lived with his mother and father in a cozy little house by the sea. He had a great relationship with his parents, who loved him dearly, celebrated his birthdays. His mom baked cakes for him. It was a wonderful life. They looked up at the clouds and imagined they saw camels, or train engines, or the tallest building in the world. They had each other, and they had their dreams. His father told him, that's what they were going, on a great ship that would take them across the ocean, right to the top of that building. The three of them, on top of the world. A wonderful place, a city where dreams come true. Then one day, a terrible thing happened. An angry rhinoceros appeared out of nowhere and gobbled up his poor mother and father. Their troubles, if they had any, were of 1 second flat. But James's troubles were just beginning. For now, we lived without Fudge.
Get up, you lazy little bug!
And that spiker.
You've already wasted 4 minutes of our daylight.
Look at him,
lollygagging in dreamland when there's lots of work to do.
Weeds to pull, wood to chop.
Work, 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 work.
I look and smell. I do declare, as lovely as a rose. Just feast your eyes upon my face. Observe my shapely nose. Behold my heavenly, silky locks. And if I take off both my socks, you'll see my dainty toes.
Well, don't forget my dearest Fudge. How much your tummy shows.
You lazy bug.
Who told you to stop working?
I finished the dishes.
A travel book? How dare you even dream of leaving?
This is the only home you will ever have.
No one else will tolerate a worthless little nothing like you.
Where did you get this? Where?
Father gave it to me. He says we're to go there one day.
Stupid, foolish man.
Foolish man, always dreaming. That's what got him killed. And your mother had his head in the clouds instead of looking where he was going.
He never even saw that rhino.
That rhino.
And the beast will get you too if you don't behave. Now get these stupid dreams out of your head and get back to work. Oh, careful, Spongy. We wouldn't want to hurt that girlish figure of yours.
Oh, shut up.
Yes?
I finished all the chores.
What a coincidence. We finished all the breakfast.
Oh, Spongy, you're such a tease.
There's something special waiting for you in the oven. Oh, do let me guess. They're not good enough for him?
What do you think this is? Buckingham Palace?
Go on, get out of our sight!
Hello there. Where did you come from? You know, you probably shouldn't build your web up there in the windowsill. Spiker and Sponge might see you, and they hate spiders. I'll be your friend, though. My name is James. That's what my mother called me. My name is James. So, it's always been. Sometimes I forget when I'm lonely or afraid. I'll go inside my head and I'll look for James. Here's something I've never shown anyone before. There's a city that I've dreamed of. Very far away from here, you know. And there are people in the city. And they come to me, but very far away. They'll say, "Hiya, James, how you doing? Isn't it lovely today?"
Ah, spider, criminal beast!
No, wait!
Sponge!
Wait, I'll get it, I'll get it!
Come on, get it! Ah!
You hit me in the face! You hit me in the face!
Oh, do shut up!
Go on, get out of our sight! Get as far away from this place as you possibly can!
Oh, I wish I could.
What's stopping
you?
Don't be frightened, James. I mean you no harm.
How do you know my name?
I know more than just your name.
What would you say if I had to tell you that the answer to all your troubles right here. Inside this little bag.
Hey! That's mine!
Of course it is! Go on, James. Have a look. There's more magic in them things than in all the rest of the world put together.
But what are they?
Crocodile tongues. Tongues. 1,000 long, slimy crocodile tongues. Boiled in the skull of a dead witch for days and nights. Add the fingers of a young monkey, the gizzard of a pig, the beak of a parrot, and 3 spoonfuls of sugar. Stew for a week, and let the moon do the rest. Have them, and marvelous things will happen. Things even you never would have dreamed of.
Like what?
Like, you'll never be miserable again. You are miserable, aren't you, James? You weren't meant to be. You know, in that place you're dreaming of, it's not as far away as you think it is.
New York City!
And it'll be much closer once you take the first step.
But how? This doesn't make any sense!
Not up here, it doesn't. The answers are in here. And the magic is in here. So, James, what'll it be? Now listen to me. Don't let them get away. Because if they do, they'll work their magic on whomever and whatever they meet first. Understand?
What is going on out here? We sent you out here to kill a spider, not to laze about.
I wasn't lazing about.
I tripped. How dare you disagree with us? Paint him, sponge!
Too early.
Wow, that makes you the luckiest boy alive. Now come inside and get dressed. The next morning, when his cruel aunts woke up, they exclaimed, looking through the window.
Spiker, look, a peach.
Oh, what?
A peach, there on that branch.
Why, that old tree's never had a blossom on it, let alone a... Wow, I'll be blown. There really is a peach tree.
A nice big one, too.
How can we get it?
The boy, Jake.
Yes, Auntie Sponge?
Now you be a good little boy, climb up there and get that peach for your dear aunties.
Can we eat it?
Of course we can. We'll share it, me and your Aunt Spiker. Now start climbing.
Yeah.
but you can play with their garbage. Garbage! And don't even think of coming near our peach. Because if you do, you know, they never did catch that rhino.
No! Wait a moment! Wait!
Brothers.
skies and clear waters.
This is all your fault!
Hey! Was it for me? We'll all be spiked and sponged by now.
The Soul Man, the one who gave you the green things, did he happen to speak to where we were going?
No. All he said was the answers will be right here.
My travel book!
And look, there's the peach. We're going to New York City.
New York? They love me there. Wonderful. They've got a whole park full of these for you, Miss Ladybug.
Central Park.
And loads of dark hiding places.
Nightclubs.
Museums and concerts.
Not to mention Yankee Stadium.
What about me?
Why, they've got miles and miles of underground tunnels. The subway. Like Father says, it's the place where dreams come true.
New York it is then. Now, how do we get there?
I'll get us there.
You?
Sure. I'll sail all the five seas, from the sunshine streets of Wagwan to the icy shores of Tripoli. Oh, Commodore Centipede. They used to call me
Seven.
Huh?
There are seven seas and Tripoli's in the subtropics. Commodore?
Trim the sails.
There are no sails.
Stir the engines.
There are no engines.
I can't work with this miserable crew. Great. We're stuck here until we sober up and die.
Highly improbable. Then it's hope. We're far more likely to drown.
Oh, no. I know. We could.
No. It's a stupid idea.
Compared to us.
We could fly.
He's right. It's stupid.
been here.
Fruit!
It's not much, but it's...
Not so fast!
Hey! You! I need this food! I have much higher metabolism! Bite me!
What?
Have you two gone mad?
You go of it! Give it!
Yeah, let's give it to me!
Ow! I got my coat!
Give it to me!
Ow! My little thorax!
I told you it's mine!
Give it back!
Now look what you've done!
We're going to starve! Waste away and not quickly!
Oh no, that'll be the easy way out! We'll linger! Slowly! Miserably! Painfully!
Nobody's going to stop! Don't you see? We've got enough food here to last us 5 voyages!
Food? Wait, what are you talking about? Is that really food?
Our whole ship is made of food!
Oh, such a clever little worm!
It makes up to me!
After you, there's nothing to take.
It's delectable!
Better than aphids!
Better than ladybugs!
What?
Sorry!
It's not dirt, but it's not bad!
Not bad? It's the best thing I've ever tasted! And I've tasted a lot! You keep to yourself, don't you?
I prefer to be alone. I was alone for a long time once.
It's nice to have friends, isn't it?
But not really.
There, I mean the answer, of course. If you get them.
No, it's in their nature to fear me. This, I cannot change. You're very kind to me, though.
Maybe it's because you were kind to me first.
You were the spy in my window, weren't you? Mm-hmm. You were my first friend. I mean, since I went to live with my aunts, they hated me.
Shh! Don't think of them now.
But what if they find us? What if we don't make it to New York in time? I die if I have to go back to where I came. They can't make me.
Nobody can make you do anything, James, if you don't let them. You are a brave boy. Now, to bed. You have had a very tired-making day.
Sis, you are an idiot!
What's happening?
I found this dime store tiniest deep at the helm!
Now we're lost!
We are not lost! We're not, or possibly very, very far south.
What's your latitude? What's your longitude?
Hey, that's personal, bub.
You said you navigate. You said you've traveled the world.
Well,
you said you've been to Bora Bora.
Well, not Bora Bora per se. And the shores of Tripoli? Did I say Tripoli? I meant the halls of Montezuma. That's what you said. Never have I heard such chop mendacity, charlatan.
Wait. He says he's seen the world, then he's seen the world! From the Sicilipede, right?
Well, I did used to live between 2 pages of the National Geographic. A very informative magazine, National Geographic. Wonderful pictures.
You are a blithering nitwit!
All right, Poppy, these are fighting words. Give me your best shot! Whoa! Good shot! Did you see what he did to me?
Serves you right.
What do we do now? Which way do we go?
Oh, it's simple, really. All we have to do is determine our coordinates and use triangulation to chart a direct route to New York.
Then there's hope!
Don't be ridiculous. There's no hope at all. We're going to be stuck here forever. We'll never reach New York. We're going to be stuck here like frozen living statues.
Dead living statues.
Don't push. But to brave those icy waters would mean certain death. Only a fool would do it.
Geronimo!
What was that?
The centipede jumped in!
Good heavens! He's committed pesticides! Away.
right back to the top. My pleasure.
Earthworm. Wonderworm. Miss Ladybug.
Charms.
Miss Spider. And the Glowworm.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hold up, everybody. I have a joke for you. How do you make a glowworm happy?
Tell us how.
You cut off its tail. It will be delighted.
That is exactly what you have just seen. Thank you.